Humans have been a natural part of Dragon Ball Z, and before the Universal Survival Arc starts next week, there is one more thing I want to check out. There are going to be a lot of human beings in this tournament, three to be exact, and that reminded me of a story in Dragon Ball Multiverse, not to be confused with Dragon Ball Super, but in this series, there are 18 universes, but instead of being different areas of space, these are different realities, so all the events in Dragon Ball Z play out differently in each universe. The humans from Universe 9 are completely different from anything we've ever seen before. With their power and personalities, you could describe them as superhumans. The average human's power goes from 0 to 10, so any normal human could be defeated by a lower class Saiyan. However, these superhumans like Krillin, Yamcha, and Tien have traits that go way beyond any normal human. The story of Dragon Ball Multiverse is a tournament between the different realities, and so only the strongest guys from each version of events get to compete. Out of everyone, the Earthlings were the strongest. Starting out with Krillin, he has taken over the role that Master Roshi had. He wears the turtle shell on his back, but the difference between this and the regular turtle shell is that the one that Krillin wears is made of Kachin, which is the same metal that broke the Z-Sword. In the first round of the tournament, he went up against Solza, and to win the fight, he slices him in half. But that's only Solza, one of Cooler's henchmen, so he's not that strong. To get a really good idea of how strong Krillin is, you have to look at his fight against Tapion. They both step into the ring, evenly matched. You can tell that Krillin has a slight advantage, but that is until he removes his shell and performs the Kaioken. Tapion cannot keep up with this, so what he decides to do is summon Harutegan. Long story short, Krillin manages to hold his own against Harutegan and Tapion, but eventually his Kaioken runs out and gets knocked out of the ring. And I know Tapion now, compared to some of the new stuff we're seeing, isn't very strong, but Krillin is still an Earthling, so it's impressive to see what he does. The next superhuman is Yamcha. This Yamcha is much more powerful than the Yamcha we know, so much to the point where he actually has a kid with Bulma, and ironically, he names him Trunks. At some point throughout his life, he gets turned into an android by Dr. Gero and becomes the 17 of his universe. It is believed that he did this consensually because that way he couldn't age, and at the same time, he becomes a lot stronger. After Yamcha, there is Tien, and just like Krillin became the Turtle Hermit after Master Roshi, he became the Crane. He hasn't done that much in the series so far, but again, to even be invited to this tournament, he has to be one of the strongest beings in his universe. That leads on to the final superhuman, and that is Videl. I think Videl is one of the most interesting ones because she has the Z-Sword and was able to use it in a one-on-one fight with King Cold. Eventually, King Cold reaches his final form and beats Videl, but that's a completely different story. The fact that Videl was even able to keep up with someone like King Cold is amazing. And those were the superhumans from Dragon Ball Multiverse. Again, not every human is like this. They aren't automatically that strong. Krillin, Yamcha, and Tien fought against the Saiyans, Cooler, and Deborah by themselves. They also train a lot, and I like to think that's how they got that strong. Anyway, I thought this was pretty interesting. Make sure you support the creators of Dragon Ball Multiverse. A lot of people who read it say that Dragon Ball Super is taking ideas with the whole Multiverse tournament coming up. Let me know what you think. Is it realistic? Is it possible for someone like the actual Krillin to get as strong as he was in this? I like to think so. I want to thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next Dragon Ball video.